stars of the college football world will be on display tonight as we welcome you to Hard Rock Stadium here in Miami. Tonight we play for the college football playoffs national championship as it'll be the Clemson Tigers taking on the Oregon Ducks.
All right, it's looking good. Real quick, I did move the hammer down a little bit so you can down. That'll be a lot better.
All set for football now in South Florida.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. Off play action, Madden. And that was going to be off target and incomplete. Cameron, the intended receiver there, but it'll be second down.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
On second down now, it's Terry. And he'll get across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
Go for the cut left for Simpson.
Looking to throw. Madden.
Are you gotta be kidding me, dude?
And it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33 as they take over.
They've got some good coverage going for
the
zone.
Set to go on offense as they come to the line. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now.
Definitely.
He used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. But they're hoping that last mistake is their only run of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
43 yards rushing for him now in his first two carries in the ball game. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And down inside the 15, shy of the
11-yard line.
16-0 on that one, and another first down. Well, one unit
go
I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense.
First quarter, no score.
We're scoreless after one. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. They'll try the left side. It's Terry. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves him with third and nine looming. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly
can go for 3 points.
It'd be a really nice play.
2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. And his kick here is good. And it's 3-0 here in the second quarter. So now they got to get to the line quickly. Play action, it's Taylor.
Come on, get on him. Nice!
The clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 44.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. so they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Back to throw. Madden. That is caught
nice.
By Anderson. And he will score. Touchdown, Ducks. Quintez Anderson, 34 yards. And the Ducks have furthered their advantage.
As a fan, is there anything prettier than a well-executed post
play? There we go.
No, it's a thing of beauty, especially when it's done like that for a touchdown.
The throw, the catch, and how about the run after to get it to the end zone?
Now after the touchdown, here's Oregon set to kick it off. And this will be a touchback, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Tiger offense ready to get after it one more time. And in a spot like this, still more than a minute, I think if you put something on the board before halftime, that would go a long way towards helping them get back into the game.
There actually is something to the psychology of the game at times, isn't there? How much better would they feel running into the locker room, as you noted, with something on the board in a positive fashion? You're exactly right. It's a great opportunity to get that done.
Second down, it's Henry, and he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up. And a throw there going to be incomplete.
Sometimes your crosses get challenged at times you don't want them to. They did try to stick to the running game on the first 2 plays. Didn't amount to much.
And now facing a 3rd and long at the outset of this drive. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Fair catch signal for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. The Oregon offense on the field ready for their next possession. And with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead should they so choose. And this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it. Cameron, the intended receiver there, and that'll bring up 2nd down. Looking to throw, Madden. This one complete to Gibbons. 30,
there we go.
10, 5, and he will score. Touchdown, Ducks. Ducks have furthered their advantage.
That score that they just gave up there, that's a tough one for their defense to swallow because they've had a tough time through the first 2 quarters. They really were determined to get a stop there.
On 3rd down, Taylor. Taylor hit. He lost the football. And it'll be a turnover. This is
there
going
go.
The way. He was under duress, surveying, trying to find somebody to get the ball out of his hands. In the meantime, the defense, they took it out of his hands.
And when the ball snapped, I know exactly what the defense is thinking. Get a sack, put him on the ground. But when you can also knock the ball free while doing so, oh, there's the bonus for you as a defender.
That'll be caught by Anderson. And he will score.
Nice.
Touchdown, Ducks. Quintez Anderson as the first half is winding down. And the Ducks have furthered their advantage. He's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating.
The Ducks set to go on offense as they come to the line. Well, the first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a wonderful opportunity for them because if they can add 7 more to their lead before the other guys even see the football, that could be the decisive blow in this game. I think that's how they're eyeing it. That's how they're approaching it.
Here's 2nd and 10 now from about the 32. To throw again, Madden. And this one's incomplete.
So far on this drive, they've done some good work. They forced incompletions on 1st and 2nd down, bring up 3rd and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure or do they play coverage on this down?
This one complete to Simpson. Nice. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
Time to give some credit to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw.
That juke was not needed.
Excellent execution of the 360 spin. Helped him out there as he gets forward for a pickup of about six. 4 yards remain for second down. Back to throw. Madden. Here's going to be incomplete. Trying to get their tight end involved finally. That's the first time that they've looked his way. He's kind of been a forgotten man in this offensive scheme.
Yeah, didn't look his way at all in the first half. And I'll bet you the offense coordinator made a note at the half and said, let's get him involved because he could be.
And he will score. Touchdown, Dukes.
Satisfied with just that. They got the first down. That was the gravy. He decided to take in the whole meal and rumbled in for a touchdown.
Extra point splits the uprights. Offense on the field, ready for their next possession. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Did they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he is into the end zone for an Oregon touchdown. A great play there. 41 yards. And this offense continues to pour it on.
Well, it has been the passing game that's really been responsible for much of the scoring so far. But let's not forget about this running attack. They're pretty good, too, is evidenced right there.
The Clemson punter out there now as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And take it right at the 35.
That's what we want. There we go.
It's a foot race. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon.
Well, certainly feels like that kind of game, doesn't it? No matter what they do, it's going to work. That might be the absolute crusher right there. A punt return for a touchdown.
Feels like there's been a lot of crushers in this game. This lead just gets bigger. Extra point right to this series after the delay of game. First and 15. Looks like he'll throw here. Forced out to his left. He finds an opening past the 40. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. I guess no need to force it when you can do that instead. First down, 18-yard gain. Off the play fake. Madden rolling to his right. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
He was able to get away earlier in the drive, but apparently all the time they put in practice finally came to the front, didn't it? They remembered their lessons and found a way to contain him when he took off on that one.
On second down now, it's Terry. Finds a seam inside the 40. And finally brought down at the 38. 138 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. Right back to him on first down. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
All right, that's game.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground.
Let's see. All right, here we go.
And it's officially celebration time in Eugene as for the first time in school history, the Oregon Ducks are the kings of college football.
cut.
For all my listeners out there, I'm just going to put it to you this way. NFL teams love championship pedigree. It's one of the main reasons why Oregon's going to be represented near the top of this year's draft. By their star quarterback, of course. In short, there's plenty of amazing players out there. But when teams look at this kid now, they're inevitably going to think to themselves, winner, champion. Yeah, obviously his measurables are off the charts, but I think his championship experience sets him further apart from the rest of the pack. Anyway, let's shift into something I read before the show. An interesting post my wife Susie sent me about the upcoming football camp taking place at Nike.
We're gonna go for accuracy.
No matter the game, that is what he aspires to be on and off the field. That competitive edge is something we both share. There's a lot of respect there. You know, I was an athlete forever, and I'm still a cutthroat competitor.
Both of you the exact same.
Neither of us have taken any shortcuts, and we both want to be disruptors.
The results from all your performance screenings were off the charts, which we expected. The DNA analysis helped too.
Yeah, you guys don't mess around. Man, I felt like a science experiment or something these last few weeks.
Everything counts. We track it all. Your sleep patterns, nutrition, lactate threshold, isokinetic testing. We need all that data to continue to personalize a plan for you.
Yeah, I have definitely been exposed to some things I've never thought about. Like speaking with a sports psychologist last week.
Take full advantage. It's not just how you perform on the field. I gotta be honest, I was a tad skeptical about you at first with all the buzz. You hear it all the time.
All right. So now that you met me, what do you think?
Everything we've seen on film has been on full display. I think that some people come here to train. They say they want to be like this. But they aren't ready to put in that type of work. They truly don't see themselves in that light. But that's not the case with you. You're wired a little bit differently, I can tell. I'm glad you accepted the invite.
It was a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. I couldn't pass it up. And I've always wanted to put my team on. If I eat, they eat. You know what I mean?
No one can make it alone. You already got that figured out. You're ahead of the game.
Hey. Hey, so I didn't tell you, but when we were hanging around at Nike, I got in contact with some reps for their other sponsored athletes. Russell Wilson's agent just emailed me. He's going to be hosting a charity game to raise funds for some fields. You want in?
Shit.
It's going to be a pickup game in Hawaii sometime in March. They're still trying to nail down the exact date.
Wow. Hawaii, and we're giving back the kids too? Yeah, you can definitely co-sign that one.
What if we told Zoe how to sit this one out?
Sitting there sleeping.
Hey, how about a little more enthusiasm? This is a big deal. You're not even in the league, and they're inviting you to line up against the best in the game.
I'm excited, I swear. I just couldn't imagine being in this position before. And to get back to the community too.
I get that. It's not about fame or the flashing lights.
I was barely able to eat off the dollar menu when we met. To go from that to cancel pros and now this.
You've got to enjoy these moments along the way. Got it?
I think you're just excited that you get to go to Hawaii.
Of course I am. And you're not letting me have my moment.
All right, Jay.
Oh, it's funny.
It's hard knowing other dudes are gonna be out there. I know we talked about this.
I hear ya. I know you would crush every single one of those drills, but we both agreed it's too risky.
Honestly, bro, they already got your measurements, your 40 time. There's enough tape. You got nothing left to prove.
Everything I'm about is gonna get questioned.
Trust me, it's a calculated decision, and it's the right decision.
Exactly. It's not like you never have the chance to prove it, though. Now, we're gonna have some private workouts lined up. A GM is getting fired if they let you slip past three.
I wanna be number one.
More prospects fall because of the team interviews. That's our focus. You don't have any meetings with teams until tomorrow. We just gotta get through the media row today.
I think it's coming across like I'm selfish. I don't love the game.
Don't fall for that trap, right? You know what they're trying to do. You've been in front of a mic before. Just let them know that it's an honor for you to be here in Indy and meet with teams.
We'll use tonight to prep what kind of interview questions you'll get. It's not just straightforward X's and O's. The most important thing is that you win in the team interviews. We need to head out. I'm gonna need you to take a deep breath. This is all part of the process.
All right. Yeah, I gotta be honest. I didn't expect to answer any questions about my favorite marine mammals. Not really my area of expertise.
Well, this one is a little more straightforward. Teams that pick near the top of the draft are generally concerned with how guys who've had a lot of success in college will handle it if that doesn't come overnight in the NFL.
Obviously, we're picking first overall for a reason. We've got a lot of holes in our roster that we need to fill. So if this is a process that takes some time, how are you going to respond?
Work together.
I understand this is going to be a process. I'll be walking into a role where I'll be expected to be a leader pretty early on. So my number one priority is to lead by example from day one. Work hard, be a great teammate, and become the best possible player that I can be. And together, in time, we'll turn the franchise around and become the example of organizational greatness in the NFL. Man, my agent warned me that some of these questions would be random. Yesterday, I was asked about my favorite marine mammals. And now you guys got me singing karaoke? Man, I can't believe it.
Well, the good news is, and I don't mean any offense by this, but we know for sure your game tape is better than your singing.
Yeah, well, I'm glad we got that all figured out.
So if you don't mind, I want to go back to your last college season. It goes without saying that you had a prestigious career. But did you feel like you needed to win the national championship to validate it?
It was a great ending.
The night we won the national championship was the best moment of my life, no question. But I can't sit here and say I'd feel like a failure if I had lost in the championship game. I had a lot of success and a lot of fun in college. And that was what mattered most.
That's right.
2 minutes.
It's gonna be good to get back home.
Mm. Y'all got some good news before you came down. Your boy graduated, leveled up. Finally got Jordan to pass me her brand connects.
Not all of them.
From now on, I'm gonna be your go-to. First matter of business is to announce that Nike's doing a brand event with Saquon for their fall football products in New York, and they want you there a couple weeks before the draft.
What? I'm so down for that. Jay, I know your favorite pizza place is in Brooklyn, but trust me, we gotta hit up Orchard Street. I'm gonna call my boy Shady and set it up. Oh, we are gonna eat good.
That's what I'm talking about. New York, New York, the city's so nice they named it.
Twice. This guy's a fool. So that's the situation. The Hawaii charity game that Russell Wilson is hosting is the same day as the Nike event in New York City that Zoe is heading to. And no, it's not possible to do both.
Man, that's tough. What do you think, Jay?
Well, the Nike event is a good opportunity to continue building up your brand. But the EA Sports event will help your brand in a completely different way. You know how it goes. I know it's a tricky decision, but that's life in the NFL.
That's what I've been waiting for.
Yeah, I get that. But what I mean is you're always gonna have people pulling you in different directions. And there are only so many hours in a day to do everything.
Yeah, yeah. I gotcha.
So, what's it gonna be?
I'm going to the Hawaii event.
play some more.
Take a shot, show them never miss. Nah, trust me, it ain't worth the risk. Yeah, you gon' feel it in a kiss. You gon' feel like you the one. You
just I just looked at my wrist, I got time today. I'm crossing the line today. The hate be so real, the love be fake. Be bumping they gums and bumping my tape. Don't go against me, they ask for my help.
Loud.
Get out your feelings and get it yourself. Might got the same shoes, but you ain't gonna step. Did you just put out, you could've kept. Yep.
Hey, 6-on-6, 21 points, touchdown, 2-point conversions, no timeouts, interceptions, 1 point. Play at 40 yards, 1 point. Touchdown after a double pass, 2 points. So it's like the yard. Alright, let's see who we got. Alright, this is gonna be a good game. It's a yard game, look at that. This is my promotion. Why not a one and roll getting chosen? Connor, walk in with frozen, make a mode and a billionaire with a we did play a little bit of yard, so. Okay. Turn that camera back on. Turn the ball too quick. Nice catch. Okay, okay. Good. All right. Hey, Sammy Lion. What's up? Oh, come on. Fine, that's fine. Fourth and two, gotta watch for the run. I let that happen. God damn it. Oh wow, okay. Okay, that's good. Nice, intercepted. Sherman? Yeah. Ready, go! Pushed me into the fucking end zone. Oh, he dropped it. It's fine. 2-point lead. because if I were to play this and not do anything with that, I would get a copyright claim. Another intercepted by Sherman. Nice. Right for that two-pointer again. Nice. Here we go. Another intercept. That's a really good play right there. Game winner right here. Right there, there we go. All right, 24-6.
Well, you just heard it from the man himself. Life is a bit different now since the last time he wore an Oregon Ducks uniform. I mean, just imagine spending the weekend out in Hawaii at an event hosted by Russell Wilson. But what he does on the practice field this week and a handful of private workouts will mean a whole lot more than what he did in the Aloha State. You know, it must have been hard to come back after relaxing on some of those legendary beaches.
All right, give him back. Let's see.
What...